Good morning. Today we are going to demonstrate the Lee Chatelier's principle. First, we'll have the FeCl3 solution 1 ml to the test tube.
Get the FeC plus ions.
After that, we'll add the potassium thiophenate solution. Now we can see the deep red coloration. If we add more, then it will get more deep. Now after some time, the deep red coloration becomes constant. This indicates that the reaction is now at equilibrium. Now we add, we divide it into two parts. To one part, we add oxalic acid.
Now this is a controlled reaction at equilibrium. Oxalic acid is present in solid form, so I dissolved it with water to get oxalic acid in
the form. Now the oxalic acid reacts with the free iron ions and thus the FeC plus ion concentration decreases. So in order to replenish the concentration, the FeSCN will dissociate to give Fe3 plus ions and the reaction will go in backward direction and the red color intensity reduces.
And again, it comes back to yellow,
yes,
as earlier. Now the second case. Now I have this test tube in which the reaction is already in the backward direction. Now I add the reactants that are the Fe3 plus and potassium thiophenate. Now as you can see, the intensity of red color starts coming again. This is because now according to Lee Chatelier's principle, when reactants are increasing, then the
reaction will go in the forward direction. So
again we are getting the red color. And this was the initial test tube at equilibrium. So these are the two cases discussed.